Yeah, actually, like Dragon Gate, the fighting scenes and like the camera actions is actually brought over to like not just wuxia films.
Yeah, it's also being applied to kung fu films, yeah, such as Fist or Fury.
Fist or Fury, which yeah, is another film that we have watched. Yeah, it stars the famous Bruce Lee.
And this is his first feature film.
Yeah, apparently it's his first big feature. And that's also how he jumped to fame, right? With his famous nunchuck scene. But he actually takes out this whole dojo, this Japanese dojo.
And the famous line.
What? Like, we are not sick man.
东亚病夫.
Yeah. So basically he's like taking out this whole dojo because they have given him that they have given the Chinese this signboard that says they are weak, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So he's trying to prove to them like, no, they are not weak. No, it's a very classic Chinese versus the foreigners. Okay, in that very famous scene where he takes out those students at the dojo, right? There are lots of camera actions and shots that we can see.
Yeah, that's somehow similar to the Dragon
Gate Inn. Most notably
is the
there's also the same like tracking shot of them fighting, and then it's also kind of choreographed. It's very choreographed actually.
Yeah.
Right.
Actually, all wuxia and kung fu films are choreographed.
Yeah.
Oh, you want to talk about your favorite scene, the one that the enemies will circle around?
No, I haven't moved on there yet.
Oh, okay.
I kind of forgot about one scene. I'm just trying to say like it's also like one whole like sort of like long take going on, like when Bruce Lee takes out like during the nunchuck scene, where Bruce Lee takes out like all of them at one shot, right? So the camera just moves around.
Yeah.
It doesn't really cut to another action, right? It just moves around.
One long take.
Yeah, one long take. And then there's also one part where he's like kicking at the camera, right? I mean, like, the action...
He's kicking at the camera,
as in, it's as if, like...
We are in the opponent's point of view.
Yeah, opponent's point of view. And then that is also, like, seen in...
Dragon Gate's Inn, where the female swordsman...
True, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's actually wielding the sword around, then...
Yeah.
And then the next shot cut to the all those villains actually, like, falling down from the... Yeah, wounded. Yeah, so similar, you can see it here. Then,
there's the close out of the eyes.
Quite a lot of zoom in actually. Yes. Also. Like in Dragon Gate Inn, right? They actually use like zoom ins for, to show an emphasis of the. Say like emphasis of. Heightened emotion in it, like this.
For Dragon Inn, I remember this particular scene where the wine was poisoned. Then after that, Xiao signaled using his eyes. So they had a zoom in of his eyes to show that he's actually hinting that the wine is poisoned. So it like plays a part. Like, it's just like emphasizing on something.
It's just emphasizing the kind of
mood tension.
Yeah, emphasizing the tension, which is similar in Fist of Fury. Where they had a lot of close-up shot of Bruce Lee's eyes. Yeah, which is very classic of his films later on. I mean, the film starring Bruce Lee. Then. There's a...
What other shots? You have all. Then there's the classic where the enemies circle around the main character.
Yeah.
And they will move around in circles. Then after that...
Yeah, it's like an aerial shot. I mean, it's a bird's eye view of them moving around loosely. then they will like get into action. Yeah, it's like a trope in all like Bruce Lee's films.
Yeah.
But actually you can see somewhat like this circling in
Dragon Gate
as well. It's just that there's only four of them instead of like this whole group of dojo people. And yeah, they were also like kind of circling before like getting to action. I mean, there's this kind of like
as in they set up the mood.
There's this build up of tension in like before the action.
So you can sort of anticipate what will happen next.
Yeah. So you can see kind of like how these early wuxia films actually influence like the action scenes, like how it's being executed. Then there's also like sound design is also very important.
We hear a lot of like punches and the swinging of the nunchuck.
It's also dubbed over. The voices are not the voices and sounds are not real. Not from the scene. They are actually all dubbed over. I wanted to point out that in a way it's different from Dragon Gate Inn because they don't really use music, right?
Hardly. Maybe because of this scene, is it, that we are talking about?
I mean it's a fighting scene, right? Like, as in, they don't really use, in Dragon Gate Inn, they actually had those, like, sounds going on, this, like, sort of a very...
Sounds that signal to you,
thing going on, kind of like Chinese opera, but then in Feast of Fury, it's more of, like, Bruce Lee shouting and screaming.
Yeah,
in the action, and then all the punches, they're amplified, like what you say, then... Yeah, it's more of it's more of the soundscape of like the fighting rather than off-screen sounds that is more prevalent in Dragon Gate Inn.
Yeah, perhaps for this scene they want to like show that there's, as in how serious this scene is. Yeah.
So these two films.
It's like so like.
But both are actually equally good. Both are actually like they win in different points. I mean, and they are different genres.
Yeah,
but the actions. I mean, when like if you watch both like one after another, right, you do realize there's this similar kind of camera action going on. So. Yeah.
Maybe this applies to like all action films.
Yeah. It definitely applies to most action films.
So
so this ends our podcast about Dragon Gate Inn and Feast of Fury.
See you at the next podcast. Bye.
Bye.